Hawk Bendelson here, animal lover and completely diggly animal wrangler. I'm out here at the El Paso Zoo, and as we all know, it's almost Valentine's Day, which means that love is in the air, not only for humans, but also for animals. That's why they've come up with a wonderful new virtual program called Birds and the Bees Love Bites. Love bites, that sounds a little negative. Joining me now is Olivia Siqueiros. She works for the El Paso Zoological Society, the support group for the El Paso Zoo. Olivia, love bites?
Yeah, I mean, really, sometimes love does bite, and in the natural world or in nature, they take it a bit too literal sometimes.
So. Okay, so do you have an example of how it might not be too good?
The most notorious, the black widow, found just about anywhere here in North America with that glassy black body and that red hourglass
right.
Underneath.
Completely diddly.
Completely diddly. She will do what those female black widows do best and the male.
Okay, well, hey, who doesn't want to come on down to the zoo with all that violence?
Yeah.
All right, so you've got that special program, Love Bites, but it really is a great way to raise money for the zoo.
Yes, sir.
So tell us a little about that.
So this virtual event is going to air Valentine's Day weekend. It's going to be the 11th through the 14th of February. And what's really cool about this event is it supports the El Paso Zoo while supporting conservation. So we're going to be talking about birds, we're going to be talking about honeybees, and then that term, love bites, you know how sometimes they take it a bit too literal. So it's a really exciting event.
Nothing says I love you like biting the head off your male.
It works for some people.
Okay, so what does it cost to be a part of this virtual event, and what will you get, and what will it do?
Awesome. So each ticket is about $65, and that's going to come with one 64-ounce growler, personally designed
like a deadly lion type growler?
A different kind of growler. It's a jug-like that you can take to different breweries and fill it with your favorite craft beer.
Craft.
But this one just so happens to be at Tin Man. You can fill them at one of the six Tin Man locations right here in El Paso. So you're supporting local.
Okay.
Also, it's going to come with some chocolates from the, you know, delicious chocolate off of North Mesa. Ah. And man, they make some great stuff for us.
Now, Olivia, you were trying to twist the whole craft beer thing into how it actually helps the environment.
Yeah.
Explain, because who doesn't love a cold beer?
I think just about everybody does, Hawk, just about everybody. But we really wanted to find a way on how to tie in craft beer to honeybees. And really, it's super simple and it's very scientific. And it's the hops that you find in pretty much all beers has been found to ward off a parasite called the varroa mite that is notorious for killing our beautiful honeybees.
That is what is wiping out whole colonies of
bees.
Yeah,
it's called colony collapse disorder, and it's a real issue that is really affecting our the western honeybee. So.
And by making beer, you make a byproduct that protects the bees?
So they actually extract a beta acid from the hops cone, then they place it around the colony, and that beta acid wards off that varroa mite. And hand in hand, craft beer and honeybees go together like birds and bees.
Birds and bees.
It's perfect.
Do you know any mating calls? Come on, do one.
I could do one. I felt like that was a little more Speedy Gonzalez for me.
Sure, a little Greedo. Mm-hmm.